In this video, we are going to see about what is tree. Tree, as I told in the previous video, tree is non-primitive, non-linear data structures. This also you might have studied the first year. So there are certain cases where you have to show the relationship in a hierarchical format. So in this case, we cannot use arrays. We cannot use something called linked list, which you have studied the first year. So in this case, we have to use a separate data structure called trees. Or this is the way we are going to store the data. I repeat, as I told in the first video, data structure is nothing but the study of storing, retrieving, accessing, manipulating the data. So I repeat, there are certain situations, certain cases where we need to store the data in a hierarchical format. So tree is answer for that. As you could see in the picture, we have an entity called employee. So normally employees having IDs, we call it as social security number. Again, you have name, address, age, salary, dependents. That depends on employees. And if you look at name, again, you may have always you have the first name, you may have the middle name and last name. So this kind of data we cannot store in the form of an array. We cannot store this in the form of linked list. So tree is the only solution for this. So this is about another way of storing data. We call it as trees. Next is stack. Stack is another way of storing data. Stack is something like your normal sack, where the insertion of data and deletion of data which happens from the same edge. I repeat, stack is non-primitive, non-linear data structure which follows first in, last out, or last in, first out. Last in, first out, or first in, last out. So where insertion and deletion takes place from a similar end or one end, we call it as top of the stack. As you could see in the picture, so we have a stack where all the disk is kept or plates are kept. We'll take it as a plate. So all the plates are kept in a container. So how we are going to take it? We have to take the topmost, the first one, then the second last, then third last. The same way you have to follow it. So insertion and deletion are taken from the same place. So this we call it as a stack. This is one way of storing data. No data, data. Next is queue. This is not common scenario wherever you go. Queues you have seen right from our beginning, right from our birth. Wherever you go, we can see the queues. And normally queue follows something called first in, first out. First come, first serve. So this is an example where bus stop people are standing. So normally this picture is taken from foreign other. In Indian scenarios, we don't find people standing in queues for the bus stop. There, might is right. But normally, if you go to other places, first come, first serve is there. So whoever come first, they'll be served first. And this is another way of storing data. Queue is another way of storing data. Next is graph. Graph is again another way of storing data. If you take airlines, flights, so flights they move from different cities. If you take domestic flights in India, so which starts from which starts from Delhi. From Delhi it goes to Kolkata, which may go to Mumbai, again it may come to Chennai. So which moves or which flies across the cities. So in this case, what happened is, we cannot represent these data using your graph. Sorry, you cannot represent this using a queue or linked list on array. So in this case, we have to take a separate data structure called graph. So this, why we need is, when there is a relationship between pairs of elements, which is not necessarily hierarchical in nature. There is no hierarchy in this. But if you see the trees, there is a hierarchical no relationship between the pair of elements. So as I told, this is a graph which shows a line flies between cities connected by lines. Next is, what we can do with data structures. What are the operations we can do with this? So we can perform different kinds of operations with the data. The first one is traversing. Traversing means visiting. So we can access every record, every node, and please make sure that you visit every node only once. It is limited to only once, and this is known as traversing. We can traverse the data. Next is searching. Searching, everyone knows, which is nothing but finding. You have studied in the first year something called binary search, linear search, finding the location of a desired node with a given key value. So if you are given, you will be given a key value, and you have to search for set of data in a which can be either sequential or whatever the format you like, you can do it, and you have to find it out. Find the location of the desired node with a key key values. Next is inserting. So insertion is nothing but adding a node or a record to the structure. Structure can be anything, which can be either linked list. Which can be either a linked list, which can be an array, which can be a tree, which can be or a graph. So to the given structure, we are going to add a new node. This is called insertion. Deletion is just opposite of your insertion. From a given structure, you are going to remove a node or records or a data item, which is deletion. So this is the four operations normally we practice in data structures. So apart from this, we have two more techniques called sorting and merging. Sorting is nothing but arranging the records in some logical orders. A logical order can be either ascending or descending. Choice is yours. So next is merging. Merging is nothing but, as the name says, which combines two different stored files into a single file. For example, think that you have two arrays. We'll take it as array A and array B. Array A is sorted, array B is also sorted, and merging is something like, you are going to combine your array A and B, and both the things you are going to merge together and put it in a single file. This is called merging. So let me repeat. So these are the operations we do with data structures. We can traverse is nothing but visiting. We can search for a given record, we can insert a record, we can delete a record, we can sort it, the given records, we can sort it, we can merge to different stored files. So this is about data structures operations. Next is, let us see what is in array in detail. Everyone knows what is an array, right? From the first year, you are going to study this, you have studied this. Let me go a little deep about arrays in this video. So as I told, array is defined as an ordered set of similar data items. So please remember that when I say ordered set of similar data items, so which have many meanings. So which is ordered and which is similar data items. So when I say int, as you could see in the screen, int list 5. So it's an ordered set of similar. So here it is, what is similarity? All 5 elements are of type integer. So next thing is, all the data items of an array are stored in consecutive memory locations. So please remember that this is again very important point. So think that you have an array with the 5 elements. All these 5 elements will be stored in a sequential way or consecutive memory locations. Next thing is, all the data items of an array are of same type. Next is, an array is set of pairs. So we have something called index comma value, such that index has a value associated with it. It can be called as corresponding or mapping. So this is about the index.